Pond scum, blue-green algae, cyanobacteria. You've probably seen this pesky greenish stuff floating on lakes and ponds. It's usually just a nuisance, but it can release all sorts of deadly poisons into the environment. A small amount of cyanobacteria isn't necessarily anything to worry about, but when conditions are right, the bacteria reproduce uncontrollably into what's called an algal bloom. These huge swaths of blue-green bacteria are sometimes large enough to cover entire lakes. Blooms can block sunlight and deplete oxygen in the water, disrupting everything from aquatic ecosystems to the fishing industry to drinking water systems. These blooms sprout all over the world and grow quickly thanks to their favorite nutrients, phosphorus and nitrogen. These elements are in great supply thanks to pesticides and fertilizers in agricultural runoff and detergents from water treatment plants. Climate change is also doing wonders for the blooms. Warmer waters, flash flooding, and hotter, wetter summers all help algal blooms explode. Although some blooms are just eyesores, some can become harmful algal blooms. Some bacteria produce what are called cyanotoxins that can injure or kill land-dwelling creatures, including pets, livestock, and even humans. Toledo, Ohio, for example, shut down its entire drinking water system in 2014 because of an algal bloom on Lake Erie that produced a toxin called microcystin. So these toxins are dangerous, and the blooms creating them are a growing global problem. Here to introduce you to the nefarious toxins is Speaking of Chemistry's own Lauren Wolf, showing off her mad structure drawing skills. Microcystin has a large cyclic peptide ring with 7 amino acids that can vary. We're showing the lysine and arginine version here. This one's the most common microcystin and one of the most toxic. Different amino acids change the potency of a microcystin molecule. Ingesting enough microcystin can cause bleeding in the liver and lead to a quick death. Some studies suggest the molecules also promote tumor growth. Anatoxin A is a much smaller molecule, but it's still a powerful toxin. It causes respiratory failure almost immediately, which is why it's sometimes called VFDF, or very fast death factor. Anatoxin A has a structure similar to that of cocaine. In fact, cocaine is a precursor for anatoxin A that's made in the lab. Cylindrospermopsin is an alkaloid toxin with lots of nitrogen and a complex multi-ring system. This molecule sent nearly 150 children and young adults to clinics in Palm Island, Australia in 1979. According to one report, their symptoms included vomiting, anorexia, and enlarged tender livers, and some even had bloody diarrhea that lasted up to 3 weeks. People called the incident the Palm Island Mystery Disease because it was only after many years that researchers figured out that a cyanotoxin caused the outbreak. And finally, saxitoxin prevents sodium ions from passing through protein channels vital to the nervous system. Although sodium channel blockers like saxitoxin can be used in drugs like anesthetics and heart medications, saxitoxin itself isn't a very helpful molecule. It paralyzes the respiratory system and kills within minutes. It's so lethal, in fact, that the US military started developing it as a chemical weapon. Don't worry, it was never used and stockpiles of it have since been destroyed. However, the US did give saxitoxin to one spy plane pilot in case of capture. This pilot was actually shot down over the USSR in 1960, but he refrained from using the saxitoxin. And who can blame him? Let us know in the comments if you have any questions about cyanotoxins or algal blooms. To do a little reading on your own, head on over to CNN for Janet Pelley's great article on the topic. And a big thanks to her for helping with this episode, and to Jessica Marshall, who has reported on the topic and provided some of the great photos in this video. Thanks for watching.